I worked in Mumbai in Ministry of Labour for 5 years. Left the job, did my MBA from IRMA. Then started BR Development Trust. Along with me is Dr. Ravi Chandra, who has done his BDS from Manipal. Then he was batchmate in IRMA. He left also his job after working 6-7 months. We together got registered the organization. And later on, Divakar was joined us. He is actively contributing in the management. And Ashish Gupta is other IRMA alumni, very senior to us, 10, 12 years before that he graduated. Basically, we are running three programs. One is Bamboo Green Gold program. Second one, Tashrashil Weaver program. And third one is Farmer Livelihood program. Financial is that since it is a not-for-profit organization, much revenue in the last 4 years of operation could not be generated, but we want to break the scale and go in for-profit domain with some participation of stake by community people. Balance sheet size has got 22.9 million and profit is just around 0.2 million. Basically, the model we are talking is that this is BR Development Trust. It's doing mobilization and institution building of SHG members, farmers, weavers. As already mentioned by me, that we used to apply local resources, means around what we can create the employment in the area. Based on that, we mobilize whether they may be farmer, weaver, or SHG members. Then, if business is consolidated, means then one private limited company will be formed, and each stakeholder will be SHG member, farmer, BDT. We have to get clarity from CA that whether BDT as a trust can participate in that very private limited company or not, or else we can also participate as promoter there. In Bamboo Green Gold program, what we are doing that we are making bamboo stick, which is used for making incense stick. Currently, we have employed 200 SHG members. There are 17 staffs. Current production capacity is around 20 tons, and sales price fluctuates between 25 to 30 rupees per kg. And cost of production a little bit higher earlier, but that can be brought down. And margin varies from rupees 3 to 8. And very special thing about the project is that to manage the raw material, or there should not be the future raw material crashes. So we are going for bamboo farming also. Bhagalpur is the district where we are doing with silk weavers. This is the district which is producing 50% tussar silk of whole of India. So we are getting produced fabrics, stoles, saris using handloom particularly. Currently 100 weavers are working with them, with us. And cost of production is around 80 to 260 rupees per meter, and there is fair margin of 10 to 50 rupees per meter. Apart from that, whatever margin we produce, that very money is reinvested in the welfare of the weaver colony, means like drinking water facility was not there in their colony. We got built a drainage system in their colony, like that. In farmer livelihood program, we are organizing farmers so that we can achieve a scale. Currently, we are having funded 1,500 farmers with us. 12 staffs are there, and we have right now linked them to the market so that they can directly realize the value of their produce. So that middlemen, the margin of middlemen can be directly put in the hands of farmer. Currently, we have 70 farmer clubs in 70 villages in 3 blocks of Aurangabad district. The story of Bamboo Green Gold is that 70% of stick is coming from northeastern state, and this gets very much disturbed because of the region that There is insurgency, sometimes landslide, road blockage, like that. Domestic market is around 200 crore and export market is 400 crore. It is growing at a rate of 10%, and India producing half of world's incense stick requirement. There is one Gaya district in Bihar where annually 300 crore business is taking place in incense stick. ITC is the one of the leading buyer, 500 metric ton per month they are procuring. Cycle Brand is the leading Agarbatti incense stick producer, and we are having tie up with them. They have recently raised a purchase order for us, and there are traders in Mysore, Bangalore, Ahmedabad, so they can be supplied the raw material on bamboo stick. In Tasar Silk, the market is around 40,000 crore, and Bhagalpur produces 50% of Tasar Silk of all over India. And in Farmer Club, we are having approximately 3 lakh ton paddy and 1 lakh ton wheat produced in that very region only. So we are talking of that much market. The process of making stick is that this is cross cutter, then cross cutter converting bamboo into this very cylinder, and from a cylinder that is sliced, and from slice that very is converted by SHG members, and that is dried and polished, and that goes to the market. Strength of that very project is that bamboo availability is very much in the region. Human resource in Bihar, you know that most of the people going out in the search of job. Less transportation cost, because 70% stick is being supplied from northeast. So always if you supply to Gaya, we supply to Bangalore, so transportation cost will be less if that is supplied from Bihar. There is professional management. Weaknesses, manual process is there. Process is very much intensive. Then opportunity, it is huge market. Mechanization is not possible. We have studied at different places that cannot be mechanized. And from stick, we can go to rolled stick, then to branded incense stick. Threat is if political situation changes in Bihar, if farmers create the cartel, and if any alternative product of incense stick comes in, and if there is a lot of competitors, because that is the only project we are doing in 3-4 surrounding states, that includes Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Odisha. So we are the only people doing bamboo stick there. Interstitial silk yarn is procured. Once there is order, then that is that yarn is dyed, then weaving, then from after finishing work, that goes to the buyer. Its strength is that there is institutional base means weavers are also participating with us. There is trust of the weaver, that is 100% owned by them. That is the very few professional setup in Bhagalpur. Weaknesses, we don't have much working capital. There is old technology there, and the market is growing, and people are getting conscious day by day that products should be environment friendly. Threat will be global recession, law and order will be always the threat there. That has changed substantially in the last 5 years. In farmer livelihood program, we are organizing to farmers. Then there is agri extension work, technology is transferred to them, and that very technology is used to increase the productivity and reduce the crop diseases. And there is community owned retail chain, then that very value realized will be directly passed on to farmers with some share being kept with the organization. Strength is there is farmer institution, means in lot of villages we can go, and farmer club can be formed. That is irrigated area. And weakness is low productivity. Equity support is not there, because nobody will pay you or support you for mobilization or organization. Once there is business, then there will be equity participation. Opportunities, because population is as it gets increased, there will be more consumption. Political environment threat, that is common there. Currently we are having 200 producer in bamboo project, so that can be raised in next 6 years to 3,000, and in tertiary from 100 we can increase Weaver to 2000, and in Bamboo Livelihood project, Farmer Club, from 1500 that can be raised to 20,000. We are having currently one unit in Bamboo that can be increased to 5, and we are having just 100 clusters in the area that can be increased to 2000, and this is the rough financial figures of scaling up. Value chain investment required is that currently we would need around 2 crore, means 23 million this year, means next 2 years in Bamboo Green Gold program, and in Tertiary Silk we would need around 10 million, and in Farmer Livelihood 14 million, and as the program scales up at different stage we would need different money. This is the 6 years projection. That's
excuse me, could you say something about sort of how much revenues you've actually taken in to date, and especially in which of those product areas?
Currently, total revenue in the whole project is around 8 lakh, means 0.8 million in Bamboo. Then in Tertiary Silk around 105 million in silk program, then around 100 million.
One question is from a legal structure perspective, you are currently, just want to understand that it's a trust organization.
Yeah.
Right, so this is, you look for an investment from as a grant or?
No, investment will be in the proposed private limited company. We have got one for already Bamboo project, means where equity will be given to farmers, those supplying Bamboo, and SHG members who are producing sticks, then BDT will have some stick. And some private investor can participate in that very private limited company. Okay. For different activity, three activities, there will be separate private limited. One we have got already in Bamboo. Currently around 1500 farmers we are working.
And number of SHG
members? No, there is only farmer club. There is no SHG. SHG we are having in Bamboo. Means around 30 SHG, 300, roughly 300 SHG members are there. The native place is Aurangabad. So this is the main region. We are three regions. So that was the strength of Aurangabad, okay, something around farmer can be done.